Hello guys, we're back here with another video, and this time, wrist wraps, rips wraps, and more wrist wraps. Try saying that five times. So, we're going to be talking about the different types of wrist wraps, how to properly wrap them, because that's a massive thing people do wrong. And, we'll jump straight into it. So we've got two main types of wrist wraps. We've got stiff ones, which are sort of similar to knee wraps. Very little stretch in that. And then we've got flexible ones, which are a lot of stretching that. So we've literally just covered the main two differences there. One's stiff, one's flexible. Not that deep, not that much into it. Primarily, I'm going to be comparing the SPD range, talking about theirs. So SPD, do stiff flexible. These are obviously stiff. And my flexible ones are already packed in a kit bag for a competition, so I'm going to be using the Strength Shot ones as my flexible comparison. But we've got stiff, flexible, we've also got small, medium and large. Large is the biggest size allowed in the IPF, which stands at 1 metre. I believe medium is about, don't hold me to it, I think it's the 75 centimetre. And I believe small's 50 centimetres. Don't hold me to it. Let me know in comments if I've got that wrong, because I do want to know. So we've covered that sort of differences. Most people do get the metre ones just because you're allowed it and it's more support. But how to wrap your wrists. So with the stiff ones, you're going to want to wrap the same with the both. You know, they're both going to be the same principle. But you essentially, you just wrap round. However, there's a lot more thought that's going into it than just wrapping something around your wrist and, you know. So, I'll just show you the finished product and then I'll explain how we got there. So you see, that's how we are. That wrist isn't going to bend. I'm trying to fight against it there. You know, you shove no end of kilos in your hand, that isn't going to budge. I'll quickly show with the smaller flexible ones as well. I'm just using my Strength Shot ones, as I said. Obviously a lot more stretchy. Boom, there you go. Again, still some sort of principle. Very sturdy. That's sturdy as all that. That ain't going anywhere. So, how do you actually wrap it? That's something we need to talk about. You see so many people that wrap them wrong. So, if you don't know, you might think, right, that is wrapped good. Look, it's around the wrist. No, that isn't actually supporting the wrist. If you look at that, look, it can move freely. It's not getting any support whatsoever because it's too low. However, on the flip side, you will get people that will wrap the wrist a bit like this. And that is too high. That isn't allowed because obviously the bar will be in your hand. One thing also to be aware of, this thumb loop, you're allowed to put it around your thumb obviously while wrapping. I just choose not to. But it must be off your thumb when you're lifting, and it's not allowed to be trapped in the bar, safety reasons. So you can't wrap too low, you can't wrap too high. You can't wrap too low because it isn't actually protecting your wrist. You can't wrap too high because it's protecting your wrist that much that, you know, it's essentially engulfed your entire hand and it's on the bar. You know, basically, it's like creating an iron hand, basically. It's obviously not allowed for that reason. So you want to find a perfect middle ground. So I'm going to talk you through wrapping my wrist a little bit more this time. So you should be able to see that. The first wrap round, we're going to cover a little bit of the palm. Going to come all the way back round again. Keep it nice and tight all the time. Going to keep covering that bit, and you can see where the wrist bends because it's not fully tightened yet. That is fully covered, it is fully supported. Wrap it round the last time. You can see that wrist isn't wanting to bend, This is obviously a smaller one. If we'd got the larger ones, like he was in competition, it would be sturdy. It would not be moving a single millimetre. That's the benefit of wrist wraps. When should you use wrist wraps? I introduced them after I've been competing for about 9 months. Same time when I introduced a belt and knee sleeves. I don't think you should be using them straight away. I think you need to develop that core wrist strength, be able to, you know, lift without the aid, much like you need to be able to lift without knee sleeves and a belt. However, I do believe they are crucial to protecting that wrist joint and keeping you safe. Longevity in the game, it's no good being able to bench 200 kilos but your wrist snaps so you can't bench 200 kilos ever again. And I really do think that, well, compared to most equipment, if we look at a lifting belt, 220 pound, wrist wraps 30 pound. They are an excellent value for money product. It's something that you should have as an intermediate lifter, I believe. Yeah, intermediate lifters should be fully geared up, whereas beginners should be still getting used to the motion, building up core strength. So then when they put the additional equipment on, i.e. the raw tackle, they should be learning that while still being at the end of a beginner stage and should be well used to all that, becoming an intermediate lifter. But I believe that about wraps it up today. Tune in next week where we're going to be doing the same sort of talk for a different piece of kit. So if you want to learn how I would say you should properly use the piece of kit, definitely tune in for that. And until next time, keep lifting that big weight.